So in the previous lectures, we discussed the local descriptors like the brief, ORB and the HOA descriptor. And all of these descriptors were local descriptors, which are primarily used to describe an image point or a feature point or interesting point in an image or some image patch around a feature point. So these descriptors were local descriptors. It means that the primary application they were designed for was to describe some feature point in an image. So for example, we have this feature point or an interest point in an image. So we form a patch around it, and the size of the patch depends on the filter, depends on the descriptor that we are applying. For example, it can be brief, it can be ORB or it can HOG, and depending on the descriptor, depending on the requirements, the size of this patch around this feature point may change. So the local descriptors were computing some function f of this image patch around this pixel p. So they were computing some function of some s cross s patch around a pixel p in an image. So this is a primary task that these local descriptors were designed for. And typically these are used for matching applications. Let's suppose we have to compute the correspondence of pixels in one image with the pixels in other image, then we can use local descriptors to describe some of the interest points or feature points in an image. They can also be used for local object detection or classification, where we form the descriptors of the patches and we train some machine learning function, and then we can pass a descriptor of a new patch, and then we can determine what object or what class of objects is present in that patch. Global descriptors, on the other hand, describe an entire image at once. So in global descriptor, we compute some f global of entire image at once. So rather than describing an individual patch or individual feature point in image, the global descriptor describe an entire image at once. So whereas the local descriptor will give us a feature vector corresponding to the patches in an image, the global descriptor will give us a feature vector corresponding to entire image at once. And that is the reason why they are called global descriptors. And the typical application where the global descriptors are used, for example, you can imagine what are all the applications where you will have to compute the entire image, the function of an entire image at once. So these are the applications that must relate to the matching of the images in that particular application. So for example, we can use global descriptors for scene recognition example. And one of the global descriptors that we'll be discussing in the lectures further actually was designed for the scene recognition application in the original paper by the authors. One of the other examples that we can think of is perhaps image recognition and matching. So image recognition, image class recognition, or matching of images, which is used in visual material loop closure. We'll outline it separately. One of the other applications might be image retrieval. Although there are not many great applications of global descriptors for image retrieval, but you can use the global descriptors for the image retrieval applications as well. One more application that we can think of, again related to the matching of images, is loop closure detection in typical VO or SLAM pipelines. So these are some of the applications of the global descriptor. And typically there's a very thin boundary between the local and the global descriptors. For example, global, let's suppose if the image is very large. So let's suppose we are dealing with image with thousands of rows and columns. So we have, let's suppose, 10,000 rows and 10,000 columns. And we can apply the global descriptor in each of the individual patches in an image. And although here it operates like a local descriptor because it is describing each of the patches in an image, similarly, for example, we can take the HUE descriptor. We discussed earlier the HUE descriptor for 64 cross 128 images. So similarly, let's suppose we have an image containing an object, and we can reduce the size of the image accordingly to fit into a dimension that HUE would take as an input. So now assume that there's an image with obstacle or object in it, and we can scale this image down to a dimension that HUE would take as an input. So we can scale down the image and we can convert it into a patch of appropriate dimension that will fit for the HUE descriptor, and we can compute the HUE descriptor of this patch. So in this case, the HUE descriptor is behaving like a global image descriptor. For example, we can use it as an image classification example, where the classification task is to identify whether there's an obstacle or object present in an image or not. So in this case, HUE is performing a task of a global descriptor, but primarily when we differentiate the local and global descriptors, by local descriptors, we primarily mean the descriptors that were inherently designed to describe a patch around a feature point in an image, whereas with global descriptors, we mean the descriptors that were primarily designed for the task of describing an entire image at once. Although they can be used interchangeably as local and global descriptors, as we have seen the two different examples, but fundamentally these were designed to do different things. So in the further lectures, we will focus our attention on a descriptor that was primarily designed for the task of global image description. So one such descriptor is GIST descriptor. It's a global descriptor. And the original paper that introduced the GIST descriptor introduced it for the application of scene recognition. So the original paper described this method for the task of scene recognition. So now we will discuss the GIST descriptor as an instance of the global descriptors. So this is one of the global descriptors that we will discuss in this course. And now we will see what GIST descriptor is and how we can compute the GIST descriptor of an image.